Doctor, is it true that you took a mammogram of your patient?
Yes, I did. And there were, as a matter of fact, 3 radiographic views which outlined the benign lesions, nodules, or cysts, which are well described or circumscribed and usually are surrounded by a thin halo of radiolucent fat.
Doctor, were those malignant lesions?
Yes, they were. They were specular, ragged, irregular in shape, and poorly circumscribed.
And is it true that they were associated with thickening?
Yes, thickening and retraction of the skin.
And was there a node involvement?
Yes, there was. It was a microcalcification and a venous congestion.
Doctor, since the presence of fat serves to identify lesions, not radiopaque substance, were they rejected or injected?
Yes, I injected them with a lactiferous duct.
And as a result, doctor, what happened?
Well, the area distorted and there was a pathological condition which is clearly delineated on the radiographs. The mammography may also be used in screening studies of asymptomatic women and in post-mastectomy follow-up examinations.
Doctor, was there a xerography of the breast?
Yes, a xerography, which is an X-ray method of obtaining images of the structures on selenium-coated metal plates.
Doctor, let me ask you about the laser radiation.
Yes, what about it?
You did laser radiation?
Yes, I did. It is an intensely strong, narrow beam of light that may be used to destroy selected skin lesions.
And, doctor, laser means what?
Laser means light amplification by the stimulated emission of radiation.
And was there, doctor, radiation therapy in the carcinoma?
Yes, there was. It is a treatment of value, A, in selected inoperable cases for palliation, B, as an adjunct to surgery, particularly as post-operative therapy following radical mastectomy, C, for post-operative recurrence of the lesion, D, in the management of metastatic bone involvement.
Doctor, was there radical surgery done?
Yes, radical surgery, which is the treatment of choice for carcinoma, since it is not possible to eradicate the disease by radiation therapy.
Doctor, however,
there is sufficient clinical evidence that irradiation has brought about 5-year cures. That is not true. The literature says that, but that is not my experience in patients treated by me for inoperable lesions.
What about radium therapy, doctor?
The treatment of pathological conditions with radium, which continually emits radiation at a constant rate, regardless of environmental conditions, may result in a superficial X-ray therapy, that is, radiation therapy used for surface lesions, for example, selected skin conditions and tumors.
Doctor, what is allergen?
Allergen is the substance which produces fibrous, that is, various allergic manifestations, for example, skin reactions.
And allergy?
Allergy is a hypersensitivity to a particular substance, eczema, urticaria, dermatitis due to drugs or Rontgen rays are forms of allergic conditions.
And eosinophilia?
Eosinophilia is the abnormal increase of eosinophils in differential white count present in skin diseases such as pemphigus or pemphigus or certain forms of dermatitis.
Doctor, what about desensitization?
Well, that is a process of abating allergic manifestations and making a person susceptible to a substance of therapeutic value by repeatedly giving him small doses of it.
Doctor, what about frozen section? The microscopic study of slides made from fresh tissue of the lesion is valuable for rapid diagnosis while the patient is on the operating table to determine the need for conservative surgery should the tissue section show a benign lesion, or for radical surgery should a malignant lesion be found. Is it too fast?
Be a little fast, yeah.
One more take.